This is Tastemakers. They're deafening.
Yummy.
On a Friday afternoon at the Dash motherfucking studio, and this is Tastemakers. I'm with my homie DJ.
Hey, bro, what's up, everybody? AKA DJ Ferrari Lamborghini.
AKA DJ Gaping Asshole.
That's right. Speaking of gaping assholes, we have the beautiful Cody.
That's a very intimidating introduction.
Yeah, shout out Playboy Radio.
Yep, Cody Renee, also Cheeto. Woof, woof.
Got a little Cheeto on the mic, you know what I'm saying? That dog rides a motorcycle. It's pretty tight.
With her doggles,
oh my god. Also got my homie back in the studio on the show, fresh out of jail, Chucky Fresh.
What's poppin' slimes? It's Chucky Fresh. And we got a big time guest in here. You know, he slept with a total of 19 girls in his whole life. He's got a slanted sideways penis. And he's the best Jewish rapper in the game, Lil Dicky!
I've actually slept with 25 women.
Oh, 25 now?
I knew that number was off, you know?
Well, yeah, you can't keep it all time. I've considered being like, every time I have sex, just tweeting like 19.
so absurd.
It's really 26, bro?
25. Yeah.
Is truly your number?
Yeah.
How old are you?
Is that low to you or high? 27.
Okay, I mean, I'm 34 and I'm like 300 plus, so.
Yeah.
But 100 of those are prostitutes.
So you feel...
It's not like necessarily like I'm bragging right now. I'm just telling the truth.
I've had sex with one prostitute, but I didn't pay her. She was just actually off work.
So she wasn't.
That's the best, yeah.
But that doesn't count. Like, we just had Mickey Avalon and Dirt Nasty in here, and we were talking to them. Like, they fucked prostitute, but not paying for sex.
Right.
But you know you're not paying for sex, right?
Yeah, I didn't pay anything.
But I mean, do you know, like, when you get a prostitute, what you're actually doing?
You're paying for sex.
No, you're paying for them to leave. You feel me? Like, you're paying for them to, like...
I don't follow at all.
Yeah, okay, so it's like, you're paying for them to leave. Because any girl, any woman you have sex with, there's, like, they feel like they're owed something, you know what I mean?
But I just don't feel like sex is always an option. So, to me, I'm paying to have sex.
Okay.
That's not, like, sex every night, I'm like, oh, now they leave, because I pay them.
You know what I've been doing recently is going to get massages with a happy ending.
Yeah, nice.
Is what? Okay.
Dismissed.
I've gotten two of those.
Yeah. Where is he?
Montreal and LA.
Oh, hey, Montreal. Sure. So you just did the massage there? You didn't go to a strip club?
No, I got the New Room massage.
Oh. Dude, the New Room massage is the best massage in the world.
It isn't porn. It's not like, in reality, it was terrible. I hate it.
Really?
I actually lost my phone that night, too.
Yeah.
In the New Room massage parlor.
You got jacked.
Hand job in one hand.
I just think I'm, you know, my pockets are always very, like...
Just all over the place.
Like, I don't say cold well. I'm going to go, like, cold.
Cold.
Yeah, cold.
Yeah, like, our manager says water. Water.
Water.
Water.
Water. I say water.
Water. Where are you from originally?
I say mom.
Ma.
Mom.
No, mom.
Mom. Wait, answer my question.
Philly.
Philly.
Yeah, first son of Florida.
Tight.
Yeah.
Right. He's not on the microphone. Yeah. No, like, just ignore him. Yeah. Who is that? Who do you bring in the studio?
That's my manager.
Is that your security guard?
Shut him out.
Mike, the manager.
Mike, the manager.
Mike Hurts.
Mm-hmm. How's that relationship?
Suge White.
Suge White.
Yeah. It's great. We live together.
Aw, that's so cute.
Yeah, it's kind of like a Will Ferrell, Mark Wahlberg movie.
Really? Tell us why.
No, really, I just picked those out of nowhere.
Okay.
It's honestly what it is like. It's like Curb Your Enthusiasm with Larry and Jeff.
Yo,
exactly,
I'm so
like.
All about that.
Curb Your Enthusiasm is amazing.
That's a lot what it's like.
You know,
pretty
what?
Pretty bizarrely so, to be honest with you.
So you just like find little idiosyncrasies in life and like trip out on them?
Oh, yeah.
When that show came out and I like went on a marathon, you know, and just fiended out watching it, then I started becoming like a neurotic Jew. And I'm Irish, so that's like a big leap for me, you know?
Yeah.
But I remember I was at a friend's wedding, and it was like, oh, do your own hot dogs, right?
Yeah.
Here's the story. This is my Curb Your Enthusiasm. So it's do your own hot dogs. And, me and the homie, everybody putting their hot dogs on. And then I put my bun, like on the little top grill, over in the right-hand corner. Okay, tell me. I want to know if you're feeling. So I put my bun on, and then I see the dude after me that I don't know. He puts his bun on in the left-hand corner after me. Yeah. And I'm watching, and I see him go over there, and, like, the hot dog's ready, and he goes and, like, checks his bun, and it's not ready.
He takes your
bun. And he looked. He didn't just take it. He, like, looked.
At you?
And no, he just, like, looked around. And then he took my bun, and I like, literally went up and, like, confronted it. And it was my friend's wedding. It was so awkward. But I was like, bro.
What did you say?
I was just like, yo, dude, like, you know you're taking my bun,
yeah,
bro.
Okay. Now, do you at all live for those conversations? Because I live for them. Like, that's, like, that's my heaven. But I know that I have that, and I can go up and confront a human being like that. That's
no, I actually was, like, freaked out on myself because I was like, oh my God, I'm watching way too much Curb.
Yeah.
Like, this guy's turning me into neurosis.
Yeah,
what was the last confrontation that you were, like, stoked on that you, like, got to go up and just, like, confront somebody?
Oh, I was in a movie. I was, like, very recently. I went and saw a movie that had assigned seating. Okay.
Right. Arc light type shit.
Yeah. So I had, like, I picked, like, my seat was, like, the direct center of the movie theater.
The one.
I went by myself. So, mm-hmm. Like, I'm very, like, very invested in going to a movie. Like, this is not, like, I'm not, like, fucking around. This is, like, not my whole, like, my off day.
You got plans, yeah.
Yeah. I get there, and there's a couple, and one of them's in, you know, a seat, and the other one is in my seat. But the movie theater's not crowded.
Okay.
Yeah. Blankly jacking you.
The movies are not crowded. So I walk over and I say, I look at my ticket, I go, hey guys, I think one of these is in my seat. And the wife or the girlfriend says, yeah, well, you know, because we just figured, like, she, like, you know, gestured, like.
Come on.
She goes, like, because there's not a lot of people in here, like, we figured it'd be okay. And I said, totally, like, I hear what you're saying, however. I said, I just have no interest in sitting in somebody else's seat, like, in case that person comes in feeling, and being the bad guy. Like, you guys have to be the bad guy. Like, hear you, but, like, I have to sit in my seat. Thank you. And they got up. And the thing is,
did they get up and then you were sitting right next to them in an empty seat?
Not only was I sitting right next to them, I then realized, like, as the previews were playing, that I'd lost my phone. So I'm, like, next to them scrambling in, like, the noisiest, like, of ways. And, like, I have to get up and, like, walk out, like, walk past them. And then I come back after I finally, like, walk past them again. Like, they're, like, shaking their heads. Yeah.
Yeah, now you're on the
joke. I've been on the other end of that, too. Like, I've been on a date with a girl. And it's the same situation. Like, I looked out. She just sits down, like, with the first two seats. Like, I was like, are these our seats? She's like, whatever, it's not crowded. And then I was like, I want to be like, we can't do this. Like, I'm not going to be the bad guy here. Yeah. Like, all I have to do is keep walking. Look, it's so lazy.
Yeah. So lazy.
Yeah, sorry.
What about the days of, like, just getting to the theater early?
Yeah. Well, I always have so much gear too, because, you know, like, motorcycles and dogs and other helmets and stuff.
You bring your dog to the movie?
Duh.
You bring your dog everywhere, huh?
Do you bring your dog to the bed?
Like, your dog is up in there, like, yo, she would lick my balls, huh?
I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I think.
Whoa.
If, like,
how's your dog lick balls?
Can we edit this? Like, I don't know. Like, if you're, like, okay with, like, polygamy and okay with gay marriage, like,
great.
I think you should be okay with a little bit of bestiality. Like,
yeah.
Whatever, like, makes you happy.
Hey, good Cody. And this way you can get to know me a little bit, Lil Dicky, you know what I'm saying? But I'm made.
That's sick. That's sick. I'm like Batman. You know, like, Lil Dicky is like a symbol almost. You know?
Dude, just, yeah.
Yeah. Someone else, everyone can be Lil Dicky.
Where'd that come? Why Lil Dicky, bro?
Honestly, I got, like, I just made, like, the first day I had my fucking MacBook Pro, I made this rap song in GarageBand, and that day I just called myself Lil Dicky. Like, I thought it was, like, I might listen to Lil Wayne. I'm sure it was a small penis joke in my brain. I'm sure it was. And then, like, I didn't think much of it, and then I, like, you know, 3 years later made a fucking Word document of names, and none of them felt better than Lil Dicky. And, like, I certainly like rewarding a moment, you know what I mean? Like, if a moment within itself, so... That's why I called myself that.
That's great.
And I thought, you know, I wanted to encapsulate, like, a lot of the opposite of what you saw in mainstream rap at the time, which was, like, very much hyper-masculinity.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
And Lil Dicky is definitely not.
Yeah, it's like...
It could have been just, like, big-ass Clitty. You could have been big-ass Clitty.
Yeah, that would have been fucking sweet, too.
Well, back in the day, supposedly, like, pre, like, the 50s, if you were born with, like, a dick that was, like, smaller than, like, an inch and a half or whatever... They would just, like, turn you
into
a woman. That was like, Google that shit. Yeah, it would make, they would just basically were like, you're better off to have an enlarged clit than you are to have just, like, a teeny penis.
I'd rather have a big clit than
Wait a minute. Are you saying that you really believe that human beings, when a baby was born with a small enough dick, human beings would be able to genetically alter that baby to turn it into a girl. Is that what you really
mean? They just like cut the rest of the dick off.
That doesn't turn you into a fucking girl. That turns you into a guy with a mutated dick.
Just with like a big ass clip.
No, but yeah, if you like start early, then you know.
And then you got that like pussy booty hole, yeah.
No.
Okay. So we won't get back into bestiality then, Cody. But I'm down. I shot a porno and a cat licked yogurt off my dick.
Every time we go
in
this every
really?
Time.
Yeah.
You shot a porno.
Yeah, with my girlfriend. I like, you know, we just made little home pornos.
And the cat thing was a separate incident.
Well, we just had this cat, and the cat was like always up in there, and like we were just like on hella Molly, and you know, like getting those like pussy entrance dick shots, you know. And then like I was like, fuck it, my girlfriend was like blowing me, and then we like poured a little yogurt on my dick, and the cat came up, and like I have a porno where the cat's like licking my balls while my girlfriend's blowing me.
That's awesome.
Is it awesome? I think it's awesome.
I think it's illegal. And would you say that you liked it?
I masturbate to it. Like, till this day.
You have a great piece for your life highlight reel.
Thank you. Yeah. I'd like to think so.
Yeah.
Recap.
Yo, you want to see it, don't you, Cody?
No. You. My comment. I like rape porn. And you're like, this one time, I climbed in this tree and almost cut my ex-girlfriend with a knife because I was like, bitch.
It was a gun. She's been on the show before. I told her, you know, I've had girlfriends be like, yo, you're like, I have a rape fantasy. And I'm like, okay. Like, let's do this.
Little choke.
You tell the story so much better.
Okay.
If a girl said that to me, to be honest, I'd be like, okay. Like, and I'm pretty anti anything like overly aggressive, but for whatever reason, like that would turn me on. I know that's disgusting.
Well, see, I'm anti like aggressive too. Like, my mom's like a woman's rights activist,
yeah.
And I was like raised like super high value. Like, I won't even let my girlfriend cook. I'm like, no,
yeah.
Let me cook for you. I don't want you to degrade yourself.
Yeah.
But. Then when like a chick, you know, I dated this chick and she was an actress and had been like gangbang raped for a role, right? And she was like, yo, after doing that role.
Wait, what do you mean gangbang raped?
Like for a role in a film. She was an actress and in the film she played a chick that got raped, right?
But she wasn't actually gangbang.
No.
It sounds like you're talking about.
She played the role.
Played the role. And then from that, she was like, yo, ever since like playing that role, I have like a rape fantasy. And so I fulfilled her rape fantasy, but what I found out is like it was fun because she was turned on and like I was like pleasing her and I was in love with her.
Yeah.
But like I couldn't bust a nut and I actually felt better about myself. I was like, yes, I'm not a rapist.
Yeah, I would have came early.
You would have came early. You were about
shortest that? Rape in history. Like a consensual rape sounds like heaven.
Really?
Yeah. My girl's like, come over and rape me tonight. I can't say stuff like this. Let's move on.
Like, no, that was like one time. Like Louis C.K. was talking about like the girl who was like really into it. Like they were like about to have sex, and then she kept pushing him off. And then the next day, he was like, "Yo, like what?" She was like, "Why didn't we have sex?" And she's like, "I wanted to. Like I just wanted you to do it." And he's like, "What? You just wanted me to like, rape you? Like how the fuck am I supposed to know you
yeah.
want me to fucking rape you?" Like,
yeah,
I'm all about like feminism and like women's rights, but like also.
But
in
the bedroom,
I mean,
be aggressive. I don't know.
Yeah,
aggressive. Just
be
go for it.
Aggressive.
Yeah. Yeah, nice.
Well, that's pretty fucking evil. Should
yeah.
we get into some music?
Let's play some music. Yo, you know what I want to ask you? Right?
Yeah, sure.
Do you take yourself seriously?
As a human being?
I mean, just like, I just think that's an interesting question to pose to you because here's why I pose that question. Because like, at one side, you could look at, like when I first came across you online,
yeah.
right? And I was like, oh, this fool is hella funny.
Yeah.
And then, like, halfway through the video, I'm like, oh, and this fool's, like, a serious rapper.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And those are two, like, because a lot of times people are either, like, comedy, rap,
you
stuff,
know what I mean?
Or they, like, take them hella serious as a lyricist.
Yeah.
And you're, like, holding these two things at once in balance.
I think, yeah.
So, do you take yourself seriously? Like, in rap, or is it, like, a, you know, is it fun? Like, where, I don't know.
No, I take myself, like, the deadest of seriously.
Totally.
Like, I think I'm, like, going to be, like, a very important rapper.
Yeah. That's a beautiful thing to say.
Yeah.
I mean, where does that come from? Like, what, do you just say that to, like, project confidence out into the world, or, like...
I think it's crystal clear to a lot of people already. I think a lot
mm-hmm.
of people, like, really can see it. It's not like, oh, he's kind of on. It's like, oh, he's, like, might be the future.
Yeah. Sick. Wow.
Yeah.
What came first, the comedy or the rapping?
Well, you know, I started rapping because I wanted to be a comedian. Like,
okay.
I never even did anything comedic either. I was just, like, everybody's funny friend.
Okay.
But, like, everybody who met me was like, whoa, like, you're really funny. You know what I mean? Honestly,
yeah.
Like, everywhere. Everywhere I went, college, high school, everywhere.
Yeah.
So I just always, like, knew that I had something. And my first attempt, I said, you have to make an attempt at being noticed for being funny. Like, you have to. First attempt I made, Lil Dicky.
Yeah.
Totally designed to be noticed for being funny.
Yeah.
And, like, stumbled into, like, whoa, that you're, like, an important rapper.
Yeah. Yeah. Beautiful. No, that's true.
It's mind-blowing. Totally.
It's mind-blowing.
It's totally mind-blowing, but it's, that's the reality of the situation.
Yeah.
What is your perception of yourself and, like, your perception?
No different. No, my perception of myself is no different. I thought one thing back then, and it was like, you were correct.
You are validated.
Yeah, it's validation.
Yeah.
And now I think the sky's the limit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, when you're proven right in that capacity, it's like, now it's like, well, how right were you?
Yeah. Ooh. You know what I mean? So yeah, because there, no matter what, like, you know, what level you achieve,
yeah,
there's just, like, another level to go for.
Yeah. So, like, serious
unless,
question.
Well, no, I don't think Jay-Z has another level to go for.
I think so. You could start, well, whatever.
He could become a he could become a billionaire. That's the next level.
Is he already?
I don't think he is.
No.
Super wealthy.
Okay, so, like, serious question. Like, what is your, like, overall goal? Like, how are you going to stay relevant and, you know, not be, you know, just the next...
A fucking pussy? What do you mean? I don't know. I do stuff from, like, my own perspective, which is so completely unique from every other rapper.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And at the same time, I'm rapping really well. So, like, that logically means success.
Yeah, true.
Yeah,
yes. Are you kidding?
He won a Grammy last year.
Really?
The best comedy album.
That's so tight.
He killed it last year. He put a video out for all of his songs on his album. His, like, shit went, like, top something on Billboard. He was, like, a dominant year.
He's, like, he's like a Harvard graduate and stuff, too. He's, like,
what a boss.
Weird Al's a legend.
Yeah, what a boss.
Yeah, totally.
Legendary.
Man, yeah, sexy.
So, it's time to move into the top five flavors.
You want to play some music?
Sure, whatever you guys feel like, you know, I'm just here for your, you know, thing.
Hey, we're going to play, like, you know, top five flavors, it's like paper, we're DJs, you know, and these are just like, it's like music we like, but it's kind of like...
And I can react after Ethan's digital song and say what I feel.
Yeah,
well,
yeah,
we want to be honest. Yeah.
The key is to be honest, bro, because,
oh,
you know, one thing that we try and do
what
different,
do you think I want
to
do?
This is not like jerk off radio, you know what I mean? Like, let's just keep it real. You can just shit on it, whatever you want to say.
Yeah, yeah.
You guys know. So,
so just get in touch with that curb.
Yeah.
That inner curb.
Smash some precious chase.
Are you feeling a little sad? Is your bone structure a little weak?
Yes.
Do you have a blunt that does not have weed in it?
Oh, yeah.
Do you have a dick that does not have a wet pussy? Well, we're about to play the top five flavors, and it's going to be that wet pussy to your dick. It's going to be that weed to your blunt. It's going to be that calcium to your bone structure.
Oh,
and this shit is going to turn the fuck up for the top five flavors with Lil Dicky.
Oh.
Hey, wait. Dave, were you feeling that? Was that a good intro to the top five?
That was awesome.
But wait, you're like a freestyle master. You want to, like, compete? You want to give us a top five flavors intro?
Please.
No.
No?
I'm not a freestyle master. I'm terribly clunky.
Are you serious? Clunky? What does even clunky mean?
You know what I mean.
I was, like, really young when he was, like, really cool, and then I grew up, and then he was still really cool to me, and he's still really cool, and then also...
Amazing story.
Blow
some more trees.
Did you blow it in Illinois?
No. You're probably just gonna edit this out, but, like, props to Andy Milonakis. He was like, "Hey, are you driving?" And I was like, "Yeah, I'm fucking driving." And he's like, "You probably shouldn't drive home. Do you want me to Uber you home? You're too drunk."
That's awesome.
I've met him too. He's the nicest, coolest guy.
Like, so fucking
great,
cool.
Dude.
Yeah,
I met him at this, like, random LA party, like the first LA party I ever went to. Like, it was such a scene, and, like, I just sat in this, like, corner, and, like, he came up, and I was like, "Yo, you want to just, like, sit in the corner the whole night?" He was like, "Yes." And we just sat there the whole night. And, like, then, like, the corner got, like, kind of cool at, like, a point. We were, like, proud. Like, really. Like,
yeah, you know.
Was it on the 22nd floor? I think I remember that party. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yo, I just... I like that, like... I feel like, you know, like he makes it okay. Like any kid out there, like any kid in the world
can rap,
could just do whatever they want.
I think he inspired me.
That's what I'm saying.
Dude, I was in high school and like I used to like see his freestyle videos and he was cool. Like, it's like, my dick is so weird. My dick has a beard.
And they were amazing. Amazing.
Yeah, amazing.
What are some of your other inspirations besides Andy Milonakis?
Larry David, for sure.
Mm-hmm. Tight.
Will Smith.
Random. Fucking boss.
You mean just like, because,
hey, Independence Day. Independence Day 2.
Philadelphia. Rapper, actor, comedian, model.
Yeah. Like, black.
Light skin black.
Yeah, all you. Yeah. All you, bro. Jewish.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Andy Milonakis though made me feel like I could put anything on my head in an awkward moment and be like, I got Cheeto on my head, but don't call me a Cheeto head.
You haven't heard that record from?
No, I actually, I remember the hook. I've heard it, but like I haven't really absorbed it the way I just did. Like, I now know how much I respect
So what, like, you know, release some of your absorption.
I thought it was fantastic. Like, really, really respect that song. Probably, like my respect for ASAP for grew even more after just, like, really absorbing that song.
Man.
It was fantastic. I don't think people really do stuff like that at all. So it's, like, really refreshing and great. And the beat was awesome. And he rapped his ass off. And it was so clearly him. And honestly, made me feel like rap's really alive right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We saw him. He was very happy. Dead.
Oh,
he fucking killed it, dude.
He killed it. Great energy.
I gotta listen to more ASAP for. I'm not like well educated enough on him.
Yeah.
I'm very much an ASAP Rocky guy.
Okay.
I don't care how bad of a mood you're in. Like, not that they would play this at like the grocery store or anything. But like, you're like a middle aged like miserable housewife that your husband's like cheating on you, and you have like six screaming kids. Like, you would be like rocking out to this song at the grocery store. Like,
are you talking about your future?
No. In fact, I was on like the main Atlanta radio station the other night, like live, and like we were talking about how no one's ever sent me nudes, and then we were like, get her Instagram out right now, like Lil Dicky, you're gonna get like flooded with nudes tonight, like Atlanta, like you better have his back, like this is for real. I got one picture the whole night of a girl with her tank top on saying I'm in traffic so I can't send a nude. That was
wow, bro.
I know we're on the radio, but can I raise my hand? Because we did a show together with four naked girls.
Yeah.
And like the
that was
and
an admiration.
Like,
that morning was ridiculous. I've never been a part of it.
You were like not into it. Like, which is the hottest girl? And you're like,
it was a very bizarre social situation. I wouldn't say I wasn't into it. I was just like, I don't really
you were
understand.
Like, you were like walking the balance between back.
Balance
beam.
Okay.
Between oh, I don't want to be like overexcited, but I don't want to be like apathetic, but like you know, teeter on the side of like.
Is that what you were doing?
Like, just like straight up, just like not interested.
Yeah, it was really.
Maybe it was me.
No,
maybe this is my social.
Are you trying to
validate yourself? I was very weirded out. I like didn't know how to behave. Yeah, it was like a bunch of girls. Like honestly, it was a very poorly written show. So these naked girls were coming up, giving very bad jokes, like, and I just, they weren't funny. They were, like, woefully unfunny. And then, so I didn't laugh, and they're sitting there naked, and I feel terrible about the whole thing, because it's filming. And it happened over and over again, so I think she's accurately describing it.
No, translation, though, it's a week-long written show by professionals, and there are three naked girls. Like,
yeah.
So,
that's the problem,
yeah.
You're writing radio.
I don't know who wrote it. I'm not saying you wrote it. I'm saying whoever wrote it wasn't that.
No, I know. I'm not offended.
Yeah.
Wait, can I put another twist on this? Is
please.
I know that.
And
like,
by the way, a lot what they were doing for just to be really clear, they were printing out pictures of my face and putting them over like all their nipples and like their vagina, and I said like, "What do you think about this?" Like, I don't know how I'm like supposed to react. You know what I mean? That is a little bit absurd to me.
That wasn't like their fantasies.
No,
to fuck yourself.
I thought it was bizarre. I'm sorry. I thought it was bizarre.
Like I said, walking the line between.
I don't think I was that.
And,
I wasn't being creepy. I was just, I didn't know how to be, like, I don't know how you don't stop.
Here, you know, for me, it's like, I always, like, tried to, like, get, you know, I've had, like, a couple threesomes and stuff, but then, like, put me in a room, like, the fantasy is, oh, yeah, like, three naked girls walk in, and they're, like, ready to fuck, you know? But that's, like,
that's
very awkward. No, it's very awkward.
Wow.
Well, no one was trying to fuck. Like
I don't think anybody.
Let me be perfectly clear.
Go ahead. Okay.
Let me be perfectly clear. What happened? It was an unfunny joke that I was expected to laugh or react at. while naked girls are delivering these jokes that over and over again, and it was very uncomfortable, as you can imagine it would be.
We also segue into the show was called the segment was called Can a Bunny Make a Funny? So, you know, it's not like a high quality production value.
I guess
I'm not saying it should have been great. I'm just explaining what actually happened. All that happened was I was in a situation where stuff was not funny, delivered by naked women, and I felt very, because I don't know how to, even if it was just a clothed man, I would have felt weird about it.
Right.
The fact that it was a naked woman made the whole dynamic a little bit stranger, if I'm being transparent.
I speak for women everywhere when I say I pardon you. No worries.
Have you ever had a threesome, Dave?
No.
Do you want to?
I'd love to get double head.
Yes.
Because you have two dicks? Like, what do you mean double head?
No, like one's on the balls and the other's on the dick.
I jerk off the double head. Like, if I see, like, a good double head, I'm like,
I had an opportunity to get double head one time, and I couldn't get hard.
Because you did, so many drugs.
No, I did 1 30-milligram Oxycontin.
Yeah, I mean but your bros were turning you off that day.
But you gave the girls 60 milligrams.
No, this is what happened. This is an awesome story. These girls are making out naked in front of a whole party of like 100 people. They whispered in each other's ear, and like in a movie, they both turned at me and they looked and they pointed at me and they said, "You, Charlie." And they brought me into the room, and then like after I came out, everyone was like, "Oh, what happened? You did get that? Like, what happened?" And I was like, I didn't even get hard, bro.
Because it was the pressure. That's
sad. It wasn't the pressure.
Well, you performed in this room.
I still regret that night to this day.
You know what I want? Is I want double head, right?
Yeah.
But I want to be like, look, like let the dick, just like let Mother Nature give the dick head, and you guys just suck. Like one take the left nut, another take the right nut, and like do a tug of war. So you're like trying to pull the balls off, and then just let the dick be free.
I like the idea of a liberal dick. The sucking on the balls, if it was just like licking balls and then the occasional like underside lick,
yeah.
You know what I mean? That's all I
need. The taint.
Yeah, and I just come, no, not the taint, like the underside of the dick lick.
Okay.
And then I'd be fine just like coming like into the air. You know?
Sounds amazing.
Yeah, that's my
way. Wait, also can I again speak for like women everywhere when you think like I'm just gonna come into the air because like I don't, it's like offensive to come anywhere else, like it doesn't just go into the air.
I get ready to go.
Like, I have like cleaned semen off of like it's gonna let your imagination go, but like and in your head, you know, you're just like, oh, like liberation, like revolution, and then it's like, I still have to clean them off the like Scotch guard couch, you know, like fuck.
Have you ever gotten cum in your eye, Cody?
I mean, I'm pretty sure I've like gotten semen everywhere.
Good answer.
Okay, let's move on to number two.
Number two. And now she got a whack ring, we fucking hoes together on $1,000
sex dummy. They use toys, I slip coke and wax while I'm... Yeah, Danny Brown's really like graphic, like aggressively graphic.
Yeah, we actually share the same birthday.
Oh, interesting. Mm.
Shout out March 15th.
What if you guys made a song about sharing the same birthday?
I'd be open to it. Consider this an olive branch, Danny.
What does that even mean, bro? Is that like an old saying?
Yeah, like me reaching out halfway. Like, let's make the song.
Phrase offering.
How poetic.
It is a phrase, yeah. You never heard an olive branch?
They're uneducated.
Are you kidding?
It must be a pencil, Philadelphia.
No, actually, I think I might be misusing it. Olive branch is like, if let's say like a woman and her mother-in-law like are bitter towards each other. Like if they're in a car by themselves and like the daughter-in-law was like, how is your fucking year going? That's an olive branch. You know what I mean?
Got you. They're just reaching out to like make amends.
So exactly.
Whatever.
So I guess I misused it or something. There's no amends necessary.
Gotcha.
It was more just like, hey, Danny.
It's like a peace offering.
But not even, there's no war. That's a thing.
Yeah. So you're just reaching out.
Yeah. This is
like, can we just say it's like
I'm throwing a smoke screen.
Can you say like a, what would it be? Let's make a new term.
I'm lost in this conversation now.
I'm throwing a lab. I'm teeing it up.
Teeing it up.
Yeah.
There you go. Teeing it up. And you're looking for a caddy.
I'm digging a hole for you to step in.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a little dark. Cody, what does that mean to feel like the black rat?
Not that you're asking me specifically, but
let's ask Dave. Dave, what is?
I think Brad Pitt's like the white stud. So it's like he's the black, great looking like guy who fucks all the girls.
Rogan.
Okay. Will Smith.
Yeah, he could have said, I'm Will Smith. Same thing.
I like when we just had was it Pinky Avalon, or I think he said, he was like, you know, all chicks have rape fantasies, but the problem is like Brad Pitt doesn't rape bitches. You know what I'm saying?
Wait,
I feel like that seems like he might be a little dark.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You don't know who Mickey Avalon is?
No, Mickey, I know. I know who he is. I thought you meant Brad Pitt.
Oh, Brad Pitt. Yeah. You think he's dark? Like dark in his?
I think there's some darkness in Brad Pitt. I don't know. I have no idea. I never met the guy, but when I see him in roles, he seems like he could be like plagued with something. Like,
you know? See, whoa, interesting.
I don't know that. No, I'm basing this off of nothing.
That's what I thought too.
Do you want to? Hey, Dave. Do you want to take acting classes? You seem interested.
Oh yeah.
You want to come to my acting class?
One, I want to learn more about it. I don't feel like that was a great.
You can audit the class.
Audit?
Yeah,
like,
audit.
Try
it
out?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the definition
Where
of audit.
Where is it? Is it in Santa Monica?
No, it's actually on the definition.
No, that's not a definition.
It's actually on Santa Monica Street Boulevard. It's in Hollywood, though, on Theater Row.
Okay,
cool. Audit.
Yo, have you ever thought about doing, like, so you said you wanted to be in a comedy, but then you did it with rapping?
Yeah.
Like, what about doing a stand-up show?
So comedy is still, like, my, like, absolute dream. Like, I want to be a comedian, like, just as much as I always have. So I see it more starting out in, like, a TV series role. Like, I think what I want to make is my own, like, Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Yeah.
I'll try to.
What would, like, can you give us, like, an elevator pitch on that?
Yeah, imagine Curb Your Enthusiasm, but Larry David is a 27-year-old rapper, so it kind of feels like Entourage to some extent.
Okay.
Oh.
As you see, like, you know, just my life is like a fucking movie. Like, honestly, like, my, like, I can tell you, like, stories that are just scenes out of a TV show.
Okay, tell us one.
Yeah.
You can't say that. Not falling out. Now the pressure's on.
All right, so I was at fucking, like, this bar, and Kourtney Kardashian was there, and I was just sitting across from her, and she was telling a story about how she pulls her kids out, you know, when she
gives birth to her pussy.
Yeah.
Oh, she like pulls them out herself.
Yeah, she did it to her first one, and she said that, like, you know, she didn't want her other ones to feel neglected.
That's amazing.
Maybe she didn't even say that. Maybe just that's how I interpreted it. She might have even said that. Honestly, I don't fully. But basically, someone said, like, at the table said, like, oh my god, like, giving birth sounds terrible, something like that. And I was like, actually, as a man, I wish I could give birth. Because I really like think it's the most human experience you could possibly have.
Right.
And and then, but like, unfortunately, I can't because I'm a man. Right.
No, well, that's what women get. Like, they have to deal with like periods and all that shit, but they get to like give birth to a human being. Like,
Thank you.
Yo, I definitely have like taken some shits where I feel like I'm giving birth. I mean, just to put that out, like I felt like, you know, it takes like breathing techniques and like I have a child, so I've been
through
it.
Have you seen the thing? It's like a stool that you put your feet on that like allows you to shit.
Yeah. Poop thing.
Yeah, the unicorn is the ad, the major ad behind it.
No,
I've seen
that. Sounds great.
It's a really interesting.
It's like
ad.
The camper.
Do you
want
to do reenactment?
You know what? I've been so. You know, as a result, I've been putting my trash can in front of my toilet, and putting my feet on it.
Wait, question. We'll start with Chucky Fred. Would you have pressed the button if you're sitting on the toilet and it has like a straight douche out the booty hole option, would you have pressed the button?
Yes, I would be interested. I would be interested in pressing the button.
Okay, so you would have pressed the button.
That's
this is
yes.
Like
going
to make me
that's
feel better
yes.
About myself.
There's
that's
not
same.
One button though, there's like 30 buttons.
This is just my experience.
Oh,
okay.
You have one button.
Dave, would you have pressed the button?
I would press the button.
You could just see what happens, right?
I know what would happen.
What would happen? You just hit that, like, booty slap.
The water would just eradicate my asshole. I feel, like, weird about the way that I enjoyed it.
You know what?
I feel like this is, like, the way, like, a product is, like, a mainstream product is meant to do.
And they have, like, settings to make it stronger, or, like...
Did they?
Yeah.
Which is the multiple buttons. That
okay, so wait. Would you press the button, Cody?
There's
you
like,
have pressed the button.
There's, like 30 buttons.
Okay,
so you press the ball.
paper. DJ
oh.
Paper.
Oh, yeah.
You press the button.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I don't know. If
I just, I wish though it was a great experience. It just wasn't. Like, it made me feel less.
My daughter, she's 13.
I wasn't trying to be creepy.
Yeah, you were. Dark territory.
Yeah.
I wish I was a teenager.
Do you?
Yeah.
Bring the mic a little closer. So.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah? What would you do if you were a teenager?
Play so much sports.
Really?
Yeah, every day we played sports.
What sports did you play?
Basketball. Yeah, you're talking to Chucky Fresh right now. This is a sports.
Oh, great.
Basketball,
great.
Tennis.
I played tennis and basketball.
Oh, cool. We became friends.
Yeah, probably.
You guys would not have been.
Did you play golf?
Yeah.
You should pick up golf.
Man, I wish. It'd be the number one sport I'd pick up. Like, it looks like the most fun game.
It's
ever.
A very
like,
difficult
that
sport.
Coordination game in the middle of like a meadow. It sounds like my dream.
It's me. I'm
terrible at it. Like, I'd love to get better at it. Like, yeah, someone should teach me.
Okay.
I'll pay someone.
Okay.
I guess I could just hire a teacher.
How much? Well, why pay me to teach
why don't you just? Why don't you just gotta go out on the course and just keep playing?
Man,
18
I'm,
holes,
I'm
you know
bad.
That's a lot.
I
of
can't
shots.
Even like finish a hole. Like I'm that bad. Like,
yeah.
Like if I actually swing with any sort of freedom, I won't finish a hole. I just like, over and over again.
I hate when my holes get finished.
Ooh. Nice. That's great.
Someone need to finish it for you?
Yeah. No,
okay.
I can do it.
Okay.
Yo, we can hang out after this. I'm single.
I don't know what I'm talking about. There are four microphones.
I'm single and ready to ramble. I'm about to give a hell.
I'm about to give a hell. I love Jesus Christ. But
like,
name drop?
Yeah, no, it's actually my grandfather's car.
My grandfather gave me an abalone.
Yeah. Yeah, cool.
Is that the Jewish thing?
What
like,
year, what
my
year,
last name is Schwartz.
What year you got? Ninth bird.
Yeah, we're friends, yeah.
What year model?
96 Toyota Avalon.
Jeez, that's old. You're not still driving, are you? Are you?
I have it. I don't drive.
After 30,
oh, still,
30 years,
damn,
it becomes a classic.
I have it. Yeah,
that's sick.
Hey, well, yo, I want to play some of your music.
Sure.
And I want to ask you, like, you know, the management and stuff. They were like, "Oh, play these songs." You know what I mean? But like, what do you want to play off your album? Like, what do you want to play, bro? Because you can play on our show.
First.
You can play anything you want. You know what I'm saying? And it's really on you. So,
you know, I actually probably selected the songs that he ended up selecting.
Great.
Let's save that money.
Yeah. I can teach a little nick stuff like push.
I can think of this. Let me turn the flash on. I can make it there. You write the hook. Where, like, who did what in this record as far as telling the story of how it all came together?
I wrote my verses. I wrote the hook a certain way that Fetty Wap then delivered a completely different.
Sick, that's great.
I like wrote the words, but he completely re-delivered the
like what your vision
yeah,
why it was
like.
Like
I was not saying hey where the gold at, babe. I was just saying I think my version of it was where the gold at, where the clothes at. Like it was like corny as shit.
Yeah.
And like his is like so dope. So like Fetty Wap made the song.
Yeah, dope.
Yeah.
He didn't. You made the song.
I made the
song. Don't be too humble.
No, I made the song, but without Fetty Wap, with me doing the hook, and it was a possibility. Like it could have happened that way. Like you know what I mean? But like, thank God Fetty Wap saved the day.
Yeah.
Yo, I just went and looked up Save That Money before we came here, just to double check on it. You got 20 million views on that video.
Yeah.
It's a fun video.
I understand though that you did you not spend any money while making the video?
That's correct, yeah.
You made money, right?
Yeah, I made about $600. But,
you saved that money on that.
Yeah. In the video, I promised the people who let me do it tens of millions of YouTube views. And now.
Like, and you got it.
And, like,
hundreds of
like as a super, like, Hollywood cynic, and, like, under... God damn. Quit laughing everything
go.
I say. I can't even, like, get a... Like, I say the. Like, say
hilarious.
The
hilarious.
But, like, I was so
she's
cynical...
Yeah.
I was so cynical, like, well, this video was made for free, I get it, like, and then I make the masturbate my dick motion,
yeah.
And then I watched it, and I, like, saw everything that you said, and, like, what you did, and then I had other people be like, hey, have you heard this guy, Lil Dicky, like, watch this video, and I was like, oh my god, like, this shit is real, people, like, from Southern Illinois, being it was real, and I'm like, you know, for once, it's, like, it's actually real, like,
for real,
it's fucking
real.
Cool, like, it's really cool, not that you need my validation, but, like, it's fucking
it.
Cool.
Yo, I think I like that I feel, you know, the bigger someone gets in the eye of the public as celebrity,
yeah.
like the harder it is to relate to them, you know? And I think you do a really good job of keeping relative to like the dude just that's like sitting there on GarageBand.
Now, I hope to always do this. That being said, like when I wrote that song, I was a nobody in my room writing a song.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I had like a small fan base, but like, you know, so it's like, my life was just as relatable as it was when I was in fucking high school.
Yeah.
So it's like, I hopefully, my fear is that my life could become chronically unrelatable to the point where it's like, I'm no longer able to like
Well,
share.
This is like the sophomore syndrome with a lot of
yeah.
musicians because you have your whole life to build material.
Yeah.
And then,
yeah.
and then you go out and
yeah,
you do years. Like, you know, radio interviews and fucking bullshit.
Yeah, yeah.
And basically you don't do anything creative in your life.
Yeah,
it's all just like
man.
Corporate machine.
Yeah.
And then they're like, okay, now we need to pump out two more albums really fast. And you're like, okay, my material is getting money, fucking bitches, driving, you know what I mean? Like
pulling up in a farm.
Just like, what are you doing? You're not doing, you know, and there's no more like heartbreak in that time period. It's all like, yo, slay hella bitch, na 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 na.
Yeah. No.
Right?
That's why I'm going EP next. Just
right.
six songs, you know? Like,
dope.
Yeah, let's try to make it simple.
Yeah.
I lose sleep over like what's going to be your next move.
Whoa.
Wait, what was before the money song though? Like that's
actually,
when I met you.
Ex-boyfriend.
You want to talk about my next move? It's actually one of the songs that I have to play. You're gonna think it's like a very, it's like honestly a risky move to some extent.
Tight.
We're gonna play it right now.
Well, let's play it.
All right, this will probably be my next move.
Great. As far as like the next putting
so,
like
putting a video. In,
yeah.
Yeah. I don't want to reveal that, but who cares?
Puts hand
Great.
On like.
Yeah.
Is it Molly or
Molly?
Molly.
Yeah.
Is that about a girl, or is
yeah.
there a drug reference in there?
It's about a girl, but it's certainly like
the situation. Aren't they
the
same
the situation
thing?
Is the hardest pill to swallow.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, let's do this. Let's do this. I have a friend that's written some. He gets paid in the music industry. Written a lot of big records, right?
Unlike all
and,
of us.
And he said, he told me, he was like, dude, the key to writing like big radio records is to like not have love in your life. Like you need to be heartbroken.
Yeah.
Because those are the hits.
Yeah.
And that's what I hear in this record.
Sure.
Is like, and those records, you know, who's buying music is my daughter. You know what I'm saying? It's teenage girls who like, no matter what's going on, teenage girls are just going through like constant heartbreak. You know what I mean? And like the girl just co-signed, like this is
yeah.
his daughter's 14, I'm 27. We're all teenage girls here, you know what I mean? Like,
but it's just
yeah.
it's heartbreak, you know. Now I don't like I was like got my heart broken once and since then I'm just like a total fucking bastard. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I get like what I liked about this is how you switched up the cadence on the first verse. There was this little like cadence switch up and it was kinda like going with the snares. And that's what I was just like, that was my moment.
Yeah.
But then the hook, way too, for me,
yeah.
too emotional.
Totally.
And I turn myself off to it.
Totally.
Because I'm like, I don't want like Eminem's like big emotional records. I disconnect. I'm like, nah, bro, shut up. I need more like ignorant,
I understand.
You fuck a bitch. You know what I'm saying?
I understand.
Put on like Travis Porter and let's degrade these hoes. Because I don't want to feel like sad.
I totally understand what you're saying. Like, I couldn't like understand more.
Awesome. Yeah, just keeping it real. You know,
totally.
Great song. You know, just I don't want to feel that many feelings, which that's a compliment.
Yeah, yeah.
yeah. Is that like true story for you? Is this like really coming from a place of heartbreak?
Oh, yeah.
Or you were like, let's manipulate women.
No. This is like about a girl named Molly that I dated for like 3 years and we broke up. And yeah.
Yeah, you want to give any more about that?
Shout her out.
Well,
she might be listening.
She doesn't like when I talk about her.
Okay.
Yeah. Fair. Yeah, I had a girlfriend for 3 years as well, and you know, it caused me some major heartbreak. I finally got over it after like 3 years. Though.
If you pay for a girlfriend, it's not a girlfriend.
Oh. Hey, you know what I was told recently is that in the first 3 years, right, you're learning about who you are in a relationship, compared like interacting with another
yeah.
person, and then after 3 years,
you're dying with the other person.
Well, the first 3 years is learning who you are with that other person, right? And then after 3 years, you actually start being your true self again. And then two individuals start dating at 3 years. So really, you don't even know what a relationship would be like with that other person until 4 or 5, you know. That's my rule. Is that just your experience and opinion talking?
Wait, you would never consider what marriage until you dated for like 4 or 5 years?
Period.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wouldn't even consider it. You're fucking, in my opinion.
Well, I don't know. What if you meet a girl and you're so blown away and you date for 2 years and you're like obsessed and like she's like, okay, I'm 35, like you gotta propose, like you would do it.
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't. But I got a 13-year-old, like I've already, yeah. No, I've already lived a lot of life, so I wouldn't.
I met a girl the other night and I already wanted to like give her a baby.
Yeah, but that's infatuation right there.
Okay, well, yeah. Let's just turn it up, you know what I'm saying? What's like, what do you want to slap that's, you know, really like party time? Because I'm fucking depressed now, bro.
Right.
I'm thinking about my, like, that bitch that fucking cheated on me. You know what I mean?
You know, you seem like a great guy to me. What about, like, a song all about guys that get girls with their personalities?
No, because that's the way I get girls, so I'm all about it.
So this is called Personality with T-Pain.
I love it.
Yeah.
Love it.
Love it.
Fragile for a moment, and I like got you. That's when I'm gonna like get that nut off.
I can't even make eye contact during sex.
I cannot.
Really?
It's so hard.
I have to.
Couldn't even imagine it. I don't think I've ever done it in my entire life. Made like actual eye contact.
It's horrible.
To be honest with you.
Really? I have to make eye contact when I'm having sex.
It would turn me off greatly, I think.
It does.
Yeah,
any emotional thing, like connection to
the... I like the emotion physically. Like, I just don't need, like, I don't need to be seeing your eyes, seeing me.
Interesting.
Yeah.
You know how I can help you out? Yeah. This is therapy.
And I think
okay.
It stems from sexual insecurity.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
And here's how I'm gonna help you out.
Yeah.
Bro, I got a little bit of years on you and
yeah.
a couple more batches
yeah.
in my, you know, on my belt, right?
Yeah.
Help me too.
Okay, check this out. I know you're the same way. Paper's like, dude, don't, you know, you just want it to be like a porno.
Yeah.
Here's how you do it. Is look at, have her get a double mirror. You gotta fuck in a room with a double mirror, okay? And then you can look at yourself, like fucking her through the mirror. And then you can have her look at the mirror, but you have the double mirror reflection. So you can look into each other's eyes, but through a mirror. So there's this nice, like, protective barrier, you know what I mean? And you can start by seeing yourself, you know what I mean? And feeling like, and you've seen yourself masturbate sexually your whole, you know? And then just, like, you can look in her eyes through the mirror, and then maybe that'll, you know. Easier way.
Don't listen to anything he says. That's some like Peter Pan bullshit. I'm like Neverland. He was really high. And he like deciphered that.
For sure. That's off of like way too many. That's 10 hits of Molly, GHB, like amyl nitrate.
Yeah.
You know, like.
No,
sex
I love looking at myself while I'm having sex more than I like.
Yeah, but we
girl.
Don't have sexual issues. But I also love to see myself fuck and get fucked, but like I don't have any sexual issues really.
Where are we going after this?
That's I won't even have the lights on.
Really?
Yeah, like that's too much.
Really?
Yeah.
Is you're just like that deformed?
Because you're like.
No, but like, what's the, you know?
No, I don't know.
I was like that.
Is it, there's so much that, like suppression? Is that a word? Well, we're going to make fun. I know whatever I say, right? You guys are going to make fun of it. But like, there's so much like sexual suppression.
Oppression.
It's like SS squared. No,
yeah.
Suppression.
Oppression.
Mostly because I was come immediately.
If you look at
that's
them,
different
then. But what about like? Why don't you just deal with like a beast, like just an ugly ass bash that like if you looked at her, it'll like make you limp, and then
no,
yeah. But there's nothing better than looking into a girl's eyes while she's looking into your eyes, and you're both coming at the same time.
Yeah,
I love. I mean,
wow,
mutual
see?
Orgasms are like what a great moment.
Yeah. What a great moment.
But you just said you didn't have that.
I didn't say that.
No,
so
I'm putting
stories.
Well, you're not eye contact.
Yeah, like eye contact. I still have mutual, like,
it's like
groundbreaking orgasms, like full body explosion orgasms.
So you're connecting physically.
No, it's emotional. Like leading up to it, it's still emotional.
There's
just
no eye contact.
Just no eye contact. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Is there wrapping involved?
No.
Oh.
Hey, so here's a question.
No,
condoms every
time. Okay.
No.
Here's a question we asked. We've asked every artist we've had in here.
Yeah.
Right? Do you like have you fucked to your music?
No.
Like you don't want to? Like, come on, it's never happened.
Not once. I've had sex to music probably three times in my life. I don't like doing that either.
That's like interesting. Meditative.
So what do you like having it silent?
Yeah. Do you want me to explain why I don't like having sex to music?
Please.
Music sets such a tone. Like, it absolutely sets a tone to the point where the odds of that tone matching what I actually feel in that moment are, like, so slim.
It can salt you up.
Can you give an example?
Too much pressure?
I don't know. No pressure. Like, the XX. I don't know. Something. Anyway.
Which is such fucking music.
Okay, yeah. The XX comes on, and it's like, doom, doom. Like, I feel like I'm in, like, an Abercrombie ad. And it's like, I'm not going to, like, it feels so contrived. And, like, I'm being force-fed my emotion. Like, I'm being dictated how to feel. That's why I don't at all like it, ever.
See, it's so funny, because I have, like, fallen in love with badges in my life because I'm fucking to Bjork.
Yeah.
Like,
or
I just like
ring.
Or Purity Ring. That's my new shit. I'll fuck to Purity Ring all day. You know what I mean? Portishead, Massive Attack.
No.
Like, ethereal breakbeat female vocal. Bam. Hot sex.
No, I have several, like sex playlists that have, like, definitely got me laid more than once.
My favorite is some, like, David Bowie, like, dance, magic dance, and just, like, humping to it.
Tight.
Okay.
I'm feeling that.
Yeah, but then when the beat's on, then you feel like you need a hump to the beat, too.
Totally.
Yeah,
that's fine.
If you were ever in marching band, like when you walk through.
No, I was never in marching band.
The only thing I like about it is the distraction of it. It's the only thing I like about it is that I can think my mind and go somewhere else.
I'll literally, like, if I'm
why
do
you go somewhere else when you're fucking, though? Like,
so
in the moment.
So I don't have an orgasm.
Okay, touche.
It's a really interesting premise, by the way, that I'm going to make a song about.
Great.
It's crazy how, during sex, both parties are completely focused. One party is focusing on not orgasming. The other party is focusing on orgasming.
That is amazing.
It's a ridiculous thing.
Really,
yeah,
that's
brilliant.
I wanted to disagree with you so bad, and then as soon as you said
song
it, I'm going to
Lil Dicky featuring Nicki Minaj, Focus. Better, and it's just, I see this, and I know that, like, you know, the way, like, I listen to my own music, and I cringe at it, you know what I mean? Because it's just, like, you just keep evolving. So if I keep evolving, and I'm rapping about different stuff, I think it's going to explode.
Beautiful.
I don't know. It's just like a logical...
I think you're on the cusp.
It's the logical way to look at it. It's
totally
a very unique product, honestly.
Yeah. What would be, like, a moment... Like, how would you see your explosion happening in a perfect world?
Long walks on the beach?
I don't know. And to be honest, I don't even... I think that the explosion could cause, like, a major... like, issue in my life. Like, I think it could be, like, a less happy life to some extent, maybe, but I hate being the guy who's like, oh, I'm famous, life sucks. Like, that'd be terrible. You know what I mean? But seriously, like, there are, like, I just watched the fucking Amy Winehouse documentary, and it, like, it's, like, intense.
For sure.
And, like, it killed her.
For sure.
I think you already exploded. You guys don't think that yet?
But
no,
there's multiple tiers. There's multiple tiers.
Sorry. Yeah. Giving you too much credit.
No,
but I retract it.
No. There's multiple... You know who Justin Bieber is? Everybody in the world knows who Justin Bieber is. He's exploded.
Yeah, I mean, but Cody's point, you definitely have exploded.
Oh, great. I've exploded.
Yeah,
I've exploded.
Yeah.
I've exploded, but like,
I was like chasing you. Like,
I know you were. I'm just saying.
Dave, what kind of girls do you like?
I like girl next door types, typically like nice, smart girls with a sense of humor. But to be honest, I don't know if I'm going after, like, I don't have enough, I need to figure out what I like. I think I like one type of thing, but maybe I don't. Like, who knows? Like, I've never married these girls, so.
Have you ever schwacked any of the girls in your videos?
No.
They're so hot, bro.
I know. I don't think I have a chance with any of them.
You definitely have a chance with them.
Well, I've been on set. I don't know. Like, I don't think I've made attempts, and I've failed.
Like the girl in the Let Me Freak video is so fun.
She had a girl, she had a boyfriend, and I, like, was totally like.
What about the girl and ex-boyfriend?
I'm completely out of my league. Like, no shot. Like, absolutely no shot. I made, like, one soft attempt at one point, and it was, like, completely shot down.
What does a soft attempt look like?
Wait.
Okay, so we were texting, and so the whole time we were shooting these videos, I had a girlfriend, Molly, and she had a boyfriend. I don't know that guy's name.
Yeah.
we go to shoot a video, and, like, we're both finally single for the first time. We shot, like, four videos prior, but both dating someone every other time.
Okay.
And this is the first time we're both single. And I was editing the video, and it's, like, it's an absurd video. It's, like, her just, like, it's me grilling meat and, like, her crawling around in the thong and me, like, eating the meat, like, off of her butt and stuff. It's, like, really, like, an absurd video. And I texted her after the video. I was, like, you don't know how painful it is to, like, go through just footage of you in a thong for, like, the whole day. Like, it's painful. And then she said, haha, I wouldn't mind if you took liberties to that footage. which makes me think like she's making a sexual comment.
Right, for sure. You need to send her a jerk off video.
Well, I'm screenshotting that, sending to my friends. Like, does this mean she's saying like I should jerk off to her shit? Like, is this actually happening? So then I said back to her, I said, honestly, not you're lucky, but like it's surprising that I haven't made a move yet. Like, there's only so much a man can take. It was like, you're lucky I haven't made a move up to this point that there's only so much a man can take.
Okay.
Thinking that, she's like, you know, set it off. And she said, there's no time for moves. We're business people.
Oh.
And I said,
that was dead.
I said, like, totally.
Dead.
She was right.
Yeah, and you should have just been like, word. That's what I was thinking, because I'm going to give you the business.
Wait, so the next video, like, is like, 2016.
Yeah, 2018.
Like the search for number 26.
Oh, good idea.
Yeah, but I'm just not that guy. I should I feel like such a loser even publicizing the amount of. I'm no longer publicizing.
Well,
you'll never.
It ends at 25.
You're not
going to
be number 6.
It ends at 25. 26 is a personal thing.
That's cute.
Let me put all my business cards and my condoms back in my pocket. Sorry, never mind.
That's tight. Your condoms. You travel with business cards.
Well, you know, you never professional party or like party. I don't know which one I need. You know,
smoke some weed.
Yeah.
Kill people.
Really like a shell with myself, not even my full self.
Right.
No self control.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Blabbering.
No.
Perfect.
That's
that.
No.
You got a good like a quick.
Yeah. Quick joke.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Two molecules are walking down the street. They bump into each other. What?
It's already funny.
One of them says, "Oh my God, are you okay?" The other one says, "I don't know. I think I might have lost an electron." The other one says, "Are you sure?" The other one says, "Yeah."
Positive.
I'm positive.
Sorry, I know science really well. Sorry, it's weird.
Hey, I got one.
That.
Speaking of jokes, what did one sushi say to the other sushi? Wasabi.
Why did Snoop Dogg bring his umbrella? For drizzle.
This guy walks into the bar carrying a dead lion. And he goes to the bartender. He's like, "Hey, I want a drink." And he goes, "Why did?"
What? Comedy.
Reset. Rewind. Delete. This guy walks into a bar and he's carrying a dead giraffe. He walks to the bartender and he goes, "Hey, can I have a drink?" And the guy goes, "Why are you carrying that dead giraffe over here?" And he goes, "It's."
Please keep.
I said a giraffe.
It's
a lion.
Wait, there's a reason.
What?
Paper, do you have a joke for us?
Don't fucking put me on spot.
Do you want to know? You want to know?
Yeah, I don't know if we can just let that go. I'm so.
I got it again. Are you ready?
Okay.
Sky walks into a bar, and he goes to the bar, and he's like, "I'd like a drink."
And he's holding a giraffe. He's holding a giraffe and says, "Hey, like, why'd you bring the giraffe?"
Hey, we're gonna burn it.